Any plans to reduce, simplify, remove the ward
system? Has there been any progress on Hippos?
Why don't you add more cover to the OPR and be allocated to PvP development versus the minimal efforts of the last 2 years?
Oh.
Well, there was no hidden subtext
in that. I was honestly on board, and then bam!
All right, we are... Are you doing sunglasses? I never noticed them until right now.
I didn't realize I was wearing my sunglasses till you just said it. It. Does it look bad?
No. It doesn't look bad. It's a look.
They're very blue.
It's a look.
I forgot I had them on until you mentioned. All right. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Forge in Aeternum, where we talk about all things New World. Today, we're doing the June Q&A and looking forward to answering some of your questions. I'm here with Katy and Dave and Lovin, and let's do it.
Coming from Dario Costa from the Creator Program, when will we find out what the new weapons will be for fall?
Not now. Right now, we really want to focus on Season 2. We're super excited about it. All the stuff in the expansion we're also excited about, but we want to talk about that in the future as we get a little closer.
What are the metrics the development team is using to influence development priority?
Yeah, so... The metrics come from a few different places. We look at industry standards for when we look at development. A lot of it comes from on the team. It's not it's more of an anecdotal, but it is a good metric to have. On the team, all the experience that folks have had. It's the future that we see for New World, that's a metric that we use. And then it's definitely coming from the players. So we have a player insights tool which gathers all of the feedback that you've provided us in game, in Discord, and it gives us all of that so that we can work from it to see, what we're doing right that we should double down on, what we can improve on, and features that people are really wanting. So those are the metrics that we generally use.
I'd add on top of that, everyone on the team has different skill sets. Not everybody's fully fungible. So if we have, some extra capacity in world art, we might look at updating some POIs, or if we have extra capacity in certain type of engineering, we might do that kind of a feature. Yeah. It comes around everything's prioritized by type and by group that's capable of doing the work.
Yeah, it's definitely a complex system that determines the future.
Are developers happy with the current burst meta? Was this the intentional direction?
Time to kill is definitely a bit quicker than it used to be. I think the fortification changes had a lot to do with that. I think it's probably a little faster than we want. We're looking at it, but I don't think it's super far off. So it's something we're looking at and will likely increase health or reduce damage a little over time, but nothing too fast.
It's fun though. We get to change the meta around, yeah. And experiment and try things and see what people respond to.
Are there plans to make more traditional raids in the future with multiple bosses, trash mobs, etc., similar to other MMORPGs raids?
Absolutely. I think we've been pretty straightforward with everyone that we want to make a good expedition before we make a raid. Now we're releasing the sandworm. We want to get some feedback on that as a boss. Once we feel like we're making good raid bosses, we're going to transition to making good full raids.
Why don't you add more cover to the OPR map?
It's something we're looking into. I think, it's hard to change the geo and those the way it's created, but I think, we've seen that range is stronger in OPR than other modes, and it's not just because range is strong, it's just the layout of that mode is very open and it sort of supports that type of gameplay. So it's something we're looking at.
And why did you buff turret HP and damage when it's still easy to kill someone sitting on a turret?
Well, the high-level goal is to make turrets a bigger part of OPR, like to make them a strategic asset that you might want to go after. A part of these changes is that there is more damage resistance while using a turret now, so that should alleviate some of this concern.
And are there any plans for PvE-only weapon perks for legendary weapon drops, similar in concept to PvP perks, where it can only work if you aren't flagged for PvP to allow for more extravagant weapon perks, or anything like that in the future?
So in general, I think we're moving away from very specific perks, perks that affect certain types or, even perks that affect certain family types, things like that. But we do think it's important to be able to separate the balancing of PvE and PvP so that we can really push the PvE stuff. Make it fun, make it a little crazy out there without affecting the balance of PvP. We have some stuff we're working on there we're not ready to talk about yet, but we will soon.
Yeah, super exciting.
Has there been any progress on Hippos?
No. but we'll let you know when Hippos are ready to make their entrance into New World.
Okay, thanks. There's a lot of people waiting for that. It seems that the New World team is expanding based on job openings, new faces. How will this affect the speed and depth of future content releases? Will more time be allocated to PvP development versus the minimal efforts of the last 2 years?
Oh.
Well, there was no hidden subtext
in that. I was honestly on board, and then, well, bow. Yikes.
So we're constantly trying to move as fast as we can and respond to the players as well as we can. And while we may be putting a little more energy toward PvE on some of our releases, I think minimal effort on PvP is not a completely fair statement. We have made some pretty big PvP changes, and we're working on some right now, things like Cross-World Outpost Rush, for example. At the end of the day, our goal is to go as fast as we can and release quality releases for players.
Any plans to reduce, simplify, remove the ward system?
Yes. No, we've heard the feedback loud and clear. We agree with it. We think it's overly complex. It creates too much of a gear chase, and a chase that's not fun, right?
Yeah.
Like what we've talked about is like the classless system in New World is one of its greatest strengths, right? Like the ability to experiment, try different builds, like super, super fun. But the problem is people are so occupied with getting banes and wards and resilience sets for PvP, they can't enjoy the fun stuff.
Yeah.
So we want to remove this complexity and allow people to dig into the fun stuff.
Yes.
Yeah, it becomes like, it goes from being this fun thing where I want to get better against corrupted to being, oh, you can't play because you don't have the maximum requirements to be as fully optimized as possible. And so it's created a not fun system, and it'll be safe to say it'll be gone by the end of the year.
Safe to say.
And I do want to say that this is something we want to bring up changes that we've made as a result of player feedback, and this is going to be one of them. So if you recall, when Empyrean Forge hit the PTR, it had two different enemy types in it, and we heard that feedback, and then we heard a resounding overall feedback, because the feedback for Empyrean Forge was, they should be all the same type. Why do I have to slot all these different gems? Like, come on, you guys. But we heard the overarching comment, which was, this is a really robust, not fun system for us to engage with. And so we took that very seriously.
All right. And coming from the creator program again, this is from XAE. Will there be an update in open world PvP or territory influence to make it more engaging?
Yes. Later this year, we have some changes coming that are going to make open world PvP more engaging. Some folks may remember the Great Cleave moment of 2022, where everybody was getting into Great Cleave and there were these amazing fights. There were just a ton of folks PvPing there. And we're trying to recreate that in a more systematic way. So something that's more gamified. So look forward to that at the end of the year.
Super exciting. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
All right. And then from Death Z Hunter, with the new gear changes, can we implement a second socket for Bane, Resistance, Ward stats instead of needing a full weapon and armor set for every faction? Could be we acquire the gems from doing the mutations on higher tiers given higher percentage gems?
We're going to go even better. As we discussed, Wards and Banes are going to be making an exit from New World, and it will not resurrect like people do. What we would do, we do still like the preparation loop, right? And I don't think gems is the right thing. We're currently thinking about using the Ward potions and just increasing their time to last a full expedition. That'll give people a little prep, but it's very lightweight.
And you can switch easily.
You can switch easily.
And from Sire Washington, will we possibly see more drastic Heartrunes in the future, such as shapeshifting?
Well, we are not talking about expansion, but I will say the Heartrune for Season 3 expansion is probably my favorite one yet. So I think we are trying to go a little crazier and try some fun stuff.
And with that, I don't know, maybe you were going to say this too, but with that, we are not going to be dropping Heartrunes as often in the game. Is that what you were going to say?
You stole my line, but go right ahead. It's okay.
everybody. So with that, we are going to be dropping them less frequently. We had been dropping them very frequently. Every time we had an expedition, it came with a new heart rune, or in this case, you know, when we dropped the Sandworm Elite Trial, it came with a new heart rune. So we are going to be increasing the time between heart rune drops, but we are looking to make really cool ones.
Going bigger, but less often.
Yeah, exactly.
That is all I got.
Cool. Awesome. Well, these questions were a little friendlier, so thank you. Keep them coming. Shameless plug, there's gonna be a video by Dave.
On Balance of Power.
Balance of Power, sorry. I couldn't pull it out of memory banks right there. Airing Wednesday, check it out. It's gonna be cool. And thanks everyone. If you like what you see, let us know on Twitter and YouTube and all those other social places. Bye-bye.
Later, everyone.
Being able to block range damage with any weapon, I think we like the way it's playing in PTR. I think overall, this is the direction we want to move in. We're happy with that.